very good evening to all of you. On behalf of HRD Forum of VIA and NHRD Chapter Nagpur, I welcome you all to this very interesting and current topic, that is Facebook's Free Basics, a Threat to Internet Freedom in India. At the very beginning, I would also like to apologize because whatever you were saying was right. We from our side had given it to Hitwada, but unfortunately they printed us yesterday. And since our office was closed yesterday, we could not rectify. That is what we discuss right now, and really I'm sorry for that. So we will have qualitative crowd rather than quantitative crowd today. It doesn't matter. So friends, it is rightly said that to succeed in life, you need three things. To succeed in life, you need three things: a wishbone, a backbone, and a funny bone. So wishbone, backbone, and funny bone. But this is a topic where if all the bones are there, only then it can work, because somebody is wishing that it should happen. There is a backup through somebody, and there are some people who are saying it is funny. So if this topic has to go ahead, and once we go ahead with the topic, you will come to know the pros and cons of what exactly is going to happen. It is also said that this topic, it is said that the net neutrality debate has, I can just read it for you again, flared up in India after the social network giant Facebook aggressively started a campaign for saving its Free Basics service. Free Basics is a Facebook non-profit initiative that aims to bring internet connectivity to the underprivileged in India. Under Free Basics, a specific set of internet services, including Facebook, was made available for free nationwide. Net neutrality activists argue that Free Basics offers free access for only a few websites, and Facebook's role as a gatekeeper in determining what websites were on that list was seen as violating the principles of net neutrality. Hence, in view of the above arguments, what happened was TRAI came out with a consultation paper in December 2015 seeking views if such differential pricing should be allowed or not. And as informed to me by the today's esteemed speaker, the date is also over. So we wanted to have this topic before that, but even today there is no problem because the topic still stands as it is, whether it is a threat to internet freedom in India or not. With these few opening remarks, I once again welcome the speaker, Mr. Amlesh Mendekar, and request Vice President of VIA, Mr. Asit Sinha, to kindly welcome him with a floral bouquet. Thank you, sir. I now request President of NHRD Nagpur Chapter, Mr. Arvind Jain, to kindly introduce today's speaker, Mr. Amlesh Mendekar.
Good evening and welcome, everybody. I have the pleasure of introducing you to Amlesh Mendekar. Amlesh is an information technology consultant with over 16 years' experience in IT. He is an electronics engineer and postgraduate in business administration. He is a certified information system security professional, certified ethical hacking and countermeasures checkpoint certified security administrator, and lead auditor for information security management systems. Amlesh has successfully deployed and managed IT infrastructure projects for some of the elite clients like Ministry of Defense, Government of India, ONGC, Siemens, Andhra Sub-Area Signaling Company, EME Center, Military College of Electronics, Mechanical Engineering, Secunderabad. Amlesh was a visiting professor for program in Information Security Management at International School of Corporate Management, Pune. Till date, Amlesh has delivered information security training to the employees from some of the reputed organizations in India and abroad, like Symantec, Cognizant Technology Services, IBM, HP, Infosys, etc. Amlesh is also actively involved in content development for many information security related services. That's a brief introduction, and now I think the floor is open between you and Amlesh. Thank you.
Thank you, Jain sir. Before I hand over the floor to the speaker, I would just like to share with you that unused talent diminishes, unused potential decays. Unused talent diminishes, unused potential decays. Unused money devalues, unused time dies. What isn't used is abused, and use it or you will lose it. So this is exactly what is applicable to this topic: either you lose it or you use it. With these few remarks, I request today's speaker, Mr. Amlesh, to please take over.
Friends, I thank VIA and National HRD Forum for giving me this opportunity to discuss this issue with all of you. This topic is very much relevant in today's scenario, where we all are using, you know, internet in some way or the other. Okay, so Facebook has come up with some new program that is called as Free Basics, and we'll discuss this Free Basics program of Facebook. What are its, you know, good things? What are its, you know, bad things about this program? And how this program in a long run can, you know, affect our day-to-day, you know, use of internet, how it will affect our business, how it affects the new, you know, startups or entrepreneurs who wants to use internet as a tool in their business, right? So I think before we start, you know, I would like to have a brief kind of a poll, small poll. How many of you are on Facebook? I think all of you. How many of you have voted for Free Basics? Okay, against, for?
Project. Ericsson and others, you know, they provide some infrastructure for internet connectivity. Opera software, you might have seen Opera browser. Yeah, so that is a part of the Free Basics or Internet ORG services. Now, whenever you want to connect to internet.org or Free Basics, you need to use Opera browser for that. And Nokia and Qualcomm, they are into producing chips and all for all these manufacturing chips for your mobile phones and the infrastructure items. So the basic idea is to, you know, they have projected it like they will provide the free internet to the people, and they'll also provide some kind of free services to them, you know, along with the Facebook. They'll provide some kind of free services to these people so that they can access internet not at the full speed what we are getting it, but at a reduced speed, reduced bandwidth, we can say. So you know, there were a lot of limitations in that, and last year it was renamed as Free Basics. Now the reason for calling it as a Free Basics or renaming it as Free Basics is because it attracts a lot of crowd. When you give something free to people, you know, they are attracted to that particular thing. So if you buy a cell phone and you have services from that particular mobile operator, you will get some set of free services on that. Okay, you need not have to pay for that. Okay, for the data and all. So that helps, you know. So that's how they wanted to project it. So what Facebook did, they tied up with Reliance Communication in India for, you know, delivering these services, and people need to connect to these services using Android phones. Okay, and wherever Reliance Communication has their operations, like Tamil Nadu, Maharashtra and some other states, people were able to connect to the internet.org or Free Basics on that. Now you might have seen a lot of ads from Reliance Communication, you know, they call it as a free net. So they are providing the services free to the people who are customers of Reliance. Now what we get in that free services, we get a lot of things like first thing is, the since it is Facebook program or platform, you get Facebook and the Facebook Messenger free on that particular service. Apart from that, in India they were offering 30 more services that includes some media news related services, like we have Aaj Tak, we have this IBN Live, BBC News, some other thing, a job portal, Bada Job, right? Then OLX, then Wikipedia, WikiHow. These are the services they offered in that particular set of 30 services. Now people who use this Free Basics, they will get all these services free. They need not have to pay anything for those services. But if they want to access, like for example, Naukri.com or any other site, it will flash some kind of thing, message, which will say that, you know, you're moving out of free zone and you're moving to some, you know, paid kind of a zone. Normally what happens, people, you know, will then stop moving to that particular zone and they'll prefer living in that particular zone which is free. That is the basic, you know, mentality of most of the people. So this is the way how that Free Basics works. Okay, again, not a bad thing, as we can see, you know, it offers something to the people who are not connected to internet and they want some kind of access to that. Now there was one program last year, there was a big debate on that. It was Airtel Zero. These are all, whenever we say zero, we call it as zero rating plan, something which is free, or you know, you get something free out of it. So Airtel offered this zero rating plan, where as a customer of Airtel, I will not have to pay anything for that, and I will get some set of websites free on my mobile phone. Okay, like Airtel had tied up with a lot of different companies, where those criticisms happened on social media. There were a lot of debates. You might have witnessed those things, media, newspapers and all. Good example is Flipkart. Flipkart was initially part of this Airtel Zero, okay. But later on, because of all this, debate over net neutrality and other things, they opted out of this Airtel Zero program. Because what happens once you're tied up with this kind of program, it gives some kind of a advantage for a particular organization. Like for example, we have Flipkart, we have Snapdeal, we have Amazon, right? These are all competing in the same particular online store kind of thing. Now, if you give some preferential treatment to one of these organizations, it is not good from the competition point of view, or you don't call it as a fair competition. Okay, so it may happen that if you're providing Flipkart on your services, you can also slow down the even if you're offering, if people are trying to go to a particular Snapdeal or maybe Amazon.in, the access will be very slow. They can change the bandwidth of this access. Airtel can change it anytime. And you'll get a reduced bandwidth to those remaining sites. So it's kind of an unfair competition between these things. So this is not good thing about this Airtel Zero, and that's why a lot of criticisms happened for this Airtel Zero. And ultimately, Tri came into picture. They asked Airtel to stop these services because it violates the net neutrality concepts. And that's how only for you have this some services which are required, like your toll free number kind of a thing, some government services and all. Only for those things you can have this free calling, but apart from that, others are not allowed. So that again, Tri came out with some consultation paper last year also on these things. They asked for the opinion from all the stakeholders, like people and organizations, where you can give your opinion to TRAI about what you want in that particular service. Okay, how that service should be. It should not violate any of the the requirements of free internet. So that debate happened, and after that, end of last year, I think in December 9th, TRAI again came up with a new consultation paper. It was called differential pricing for data services. Now, how this happened? Last year, they had already taken the issue, and they have come up with some kind of a opinion on that it will not be allowed. But again, because Facebook pushed it, they used their all PR techniques and their money power and lobbying and all to push their free basics program in India, and that's why again TRAI came up with the new consultation paper. Okay, so in fact, January 7 was the last date for giving your opinion to TRAI. January 14th was that 7 days was given for some questions raised by TRAI, who were given the opinions. That question thing happened till 14th, and now TRAI will come up with their people have given to on that particular issue. But this is how this lobbying and all will work, and in future also we can see this kind of consultation papers coming out from TRAI on something regarding internet. So we need to understand how Facebook free basic is just one example of that. Okay, but in future also you might have this kind of programs where there are threats to your internet freedom. Okay, and how we need to address to those issues. So let us understand how actually internet works. Why this free basics is we call it as a threat to internet freedom. So normally what we do is whenever you want to connect to internet, we have your mobile phone or laptop or computer. What we do, we take some services, internet services from the service provider, internet service providers, right? We pay them, and then once you connect to internet, you get all internet on your system. Okay, I mean all means you can access any website. Okay, cannot stop you from accessing anything, right? It's free, everything is free, you know. Even if I have a small website hosted on my system which is connected to internet, you'll be able to access it from outside, right? So it's kind of a fair, you know, kind of a treatment to all the websites on the internet. But with Facebook Free Basics, how it works? Now, Facebook Free Basics, it works as we have discussed on mobile phones, right? You have a program called internet.org which you need to load on your system, on your mobile. Now what happens, this program with all this set of services including Facebook and other services, it gets connected to a server which is Facebook server. It's called as internet.org proxy server, okay? And through this proxy, then whatever sites what you have discussed earlier, you know, the sites like OLX or any other site, they will be connected to this Facebook server here, right? So what is happening here is your data is moving from your mobile phone to Facebook server and then going to the actual site, right? Now, Facebook has decided the number of services, like in this example we are taking 30 services. So only 30 services will be available, and whatever data you are accessing for those services will pass through this Facebook server, right? Now what will happen? Now you have done some kind of a, you know, divided the internet into small parts. Okay, like for example, Facebook Free Basics, they are offering you services. You might get only access to some of the services, like, you know, we have discussed Bada Job or OLX or any other thing. Rest of the services are outside its scope. You cannot access these services, right? You cannot go to other sites, right? So now this has created a separate environment, you know, part of internet in a big internet. Okay. Now suppose tomorrow any other company, say Google. Google is also a big company with a lot of money power. They will also come up with some kind of program. Now they will have their own set of services which will be something different. Okay. Now what happens, you know, if I'm hosting a site, okay, my site will not be accessible to the limited set of services here. Okay.
They will not be available to Facebook.
Yeah. So what I need to do, I need to subscribe to Facebook first. Okay. I need to maybe sometimes I need to pay Facebook to put my site on that in that particular zone so that people are able to access those services. Right? So if tomorrow Google comes up, I need to pay Google also. Okay. So this is, I don't know, you know, my site is available in other countries anywhere. Right now I know, yes, if I am hosting a site, any part of, you know, globe you go, you can access my site, this site. Right? So, but this will not happen with this kind of thing. So people will have their own way of accessing the internet, only limited sites will be available. So this is not a good thing for the internet also. Right? So this is one of the big drawback of this Facebook Free Basics program. Right? Now, what is internet freedom? Like, you know, any other freedom? Internet freedom talks about, you know, every person, like, they will have some kind of a right to access the internet, okay? Right to access any information on the internet. They can, you know, do a lot of new things on the internet. These are, the things which we talk about, you know, freedom in India, kind of. People do have some kind of freedom, okay? So we have right to, you know, information, we have right to, you know, voice your opinion. So these are the things which are available on the internet also right now. But these kind of programs can have some serious implications on these kind of internet freedom and net neutrality concepts. The net neutrality concept says that, you know, equal treatment for all internet traffic, okay, without any priority given to any particular service. If you give some priority to any particular service, it is going to hamper the services of other people. Okay, it gives some undue, kind of an advantage to some particular services, and it will be a disadvantage to someone else. So this is not a, you know, level playing field actually. So that's the concept of net neutrality, and that's where a big debate started again on Free Basics, whether it is, you know, against net neutrality or it's supporting the net neutrality concept. three basic things. What the net neutrality concept says that, all the websites should be equally accessible. Just now what we are having right now, you know, all sites are equally accessible to every person. Right? You just click on internet, browse any site, anywhere from the world, you will get it. Without any discrimination and restrictions. Right now there is no restrictions. It depends on your internet speed, you know, whatever plan you have taken. But ultimately you get access to that particular site, maybe at slower, you know, speed or maybe at higher speed. Speed is not the issue, but accessing the site is the major important issue. So you get that access right now. And that is the concept of net neutrality, what we are trying to address here. Now, this is the case where we are having internet today. Everything is available at same speed. This will happen after you have this program like Airtel Zero or Facebook Free Basics, where only limited sites will be available, and they can also throttle the bandwidth of, you know, other websites also. So you get full speed or more speed on particular website, like for Flipkart, maybe for other Snapdeal and all. Normally, when you know what they do is, you know, if you have some, you know, service available, maybe they will not allow some competitor services on that particular site also. That can also, they will not be part of it. So that again creates a huge problem. Right. That's the debate actually. That's where the debate has started. You have to go for open internet, pay it and then access it. But again, like if any of this, you know, Airtel or Facebook, you know, they are providing this kind of services. Now take for example Airtel, they are internet service providers. They can play around. If you make them, you know, responsible for giving all this access, you know, they can play around with the bandwidth of other sites also. Okay, even if it's on the open internet also. Okay, there are chances, you know. So that's where we don't want them to have that particular right to control this, you know, bandwidth and all. Right? So it needs to be free. That's the concept of neutrality. Now, why Facebook is so much interested in India? The reason behind it is, like, you know, how it operates. Basically, Facebook, they track all the users. Okay. They take all this, you know, information of the users. You, whenever you, you know, log in on this Facebook website, you put your opinions, you